In this video, you are going to learn how to merge two different models in ETABS. Usually, we do this when their models are complex. So the given situation is shown. We will be modeling the side model independently and the central model independently. And in the end, we will merge these two models in ETABS. So I'm going to show you how we will be merging these models and insert them in the correct location for the combined model. First of all, starting with defining the grids, and there will be a slight change in the modeling techniques. So defining the grids for the central model first. So I'll be modeling the central model first, starting with defining the section properties of the slab. Taking random properties, as our concern here is only to learn how to merge the models. Let's take wall thickness as 12 inches. Okay. The property modifiers will be taken as 0.7 for now. In order to understand the correct property modifiers for wall, we have to go to the channel and watch shear wall design video. Now adding property modifiers for the slab section, that is 0.25 according to ACI code. Now we'll be start modeling the structure. For time being, we are modeling the central model first. Starting with modeling the wall, that is shear wall of the structure. Since it's a central model, so we have to follow the layout shown. Now I'll be drawing the slab. Let's select the option by picking the edges. The slab is drawn. Now you can also draw the columns if they are present in your structure, but right now our structure is purely on walls and that loads is taken by the shear walls. So now we will be drawing the wall stacks for the middle part of the structure, as we were shown in the layout. So now we will be setting the dimensions for the wall stacks and its openings. So the length and the dimension which we are setting is shown on the figure respectively. The thickness of the walls selected is 12 inches, which is okay. The opening height is 6.5 inches, but we take it as 7 feet. So let's make it 7 feet here. The opening width is 4 feet. Let's just cancel the mirror option for now. So the wall stacks you see is drawn throughout the structure. So we won't be requiring to replicate this part of the structure to the other stories. While the rest we have modeled will be replicated to the next stories. So first we have to hide this part so that it doesn't replicate. Let's first turn off the visibility of the slab. So now first we will turn off the visibility of the floors and hide this wall. now we will show all the objects and we will replicate this to the other stories. Except the base where supports will be present. Now we will show visibility of all the objects. So now we have modeled the central part of the structure. Let's save it as main model, as we will be importing the kernel model in this one. Now we will be opening another etabs and start modeling the kernel model. First of all, defining the grids. It's not important you define the grid spacing according to the first model. You can define the grid spacing independent of the first or the other model which you have to merge with. So now we will be defining the names of the properties same as we have defined in the other model, so that there is no conflict of the properties. Similarly, for the walls, we will define the same name and the properties as we have defined in the other model with which we will merge. Even if there are beams and columns present in the structure, you will have to do the same. That means that you will have to assign the property names same in both the models and their properties, so that there is no conflict of properties. The main model should have all the properties of the individual models defined. So we will be modeling the kernel model here. Now we will be requiring to model a wall stack here. Wall stack. Let's select an L-shaped wall stack of 5 feet. We have to rotate it by an angle. The angle is given here. Let's make it 90 degrees so it fits this corner. I hope the snap catches the slab edges. Now we have to rotate it further for the other corner. Let's try rotating 180 degrees. So it is not fitting. Let's make it 270. So now it fits the corner. Now you have to make it to the other corner. 360 degrees is not fitting again. So we will have to, actually the property vanished, so we will start drawing it again. Let's select the L shape again. And the property is redefined as the previous one. Let's make it 180 degrees. Yeah, so it fits nicely. We will also importantly check whether the joints are overlapping in the structure where the structure is once modeled. So now for the staircase shaft, we will have to define the openings and the lift opening. So it's the core wall. So we are defining the core wall dimensions here. For now, we are taking the dimensions arbitrarily, as our function purpose here is to merge the model. It's a practical model of a building structure. Basically, it's a hotel building. Defining the parameters. The parameters are already shown on the window, which ETABS 2016 gives a preview. Now defining the various lengths. Now we will be defining the x length. Let's make it 3 feet. So the thickness parts now the thickness t1 opening width is 5 feet and the height is 7 feet. Now you can see the preview of the thickness we are setting. So it's changing the thickness of the walls wherever we want to. Let's make it 12 for all for time being. So we don't want it to conflict with the central model. So we'll set the wall as such it does not conflict with the rest. And now it fits it nicely. Again, the wall stacks are modeled to the rest of the stories, so we won't be requiring to replicate them. You can also set the properties of the wall by overriding them. Now we'll need to replicate this part of the slab which is not already replicated. So now we'll be replicating it. Now saving the side model after modeling the is complete. Now we'll be copying the side model into the main model. Let's just press copy, or if the copying option is freezed, so just select all the model and press Ctrl plus C, or simply hold Ctrl C, then the paste option will. Now if the paste option is not available, then press Ctrl V in the main model. Since we have to move 30 feet in x-axis and 30 feet in y-axis, the origin of the side model is shifted to 30 feet in x-axis and 30 feet in y-axis. Now there is one void part left. So we can go and draw it in the main model. Drawing the slab in the leftover portion, select all stories and click on this part. Now we have drawn now assign the slab properties uniformly to all of the sections. So the property was defined similarly in the other module. Still, we will override the property so that the analysis procedure is same for both of the sections. Now we have to replicate it on four sides of the model. For that, we will have to hide the center model in order to allow easy selection of the side model. We may simply mirror it by using the replicating option, but for learning point of view, we have to replicate it and then rotate it. Now replicating it linearly. Since we are trying to go in negative dimension, let's say it as minus 40. Right. Now minus 50 fits right, I guess. So it's okay. Now we will have to rotate it. But first we'll replicate it by select, make sure all stories option is selected, replicate it on the bottom side. Now once replication is done, we need to get a center point in the parts which have to be rotated. In order to get a center point, we need to draw frame with property of null line. Similarly, in the rest of the corner sections. Now we have to get break the blinds at intersections so that we get a point which is the center point of the individual buildings. Now we got a center point. Now we will try to rotate it about that center point. According to the layout which was shown to us. Let's make it a rotation of 90 degrees. So it does not fit nicely. According to the layout shown, we will rotate it again. By 180 degrees. Now it is done. I will try the same here. Selected the center point of rotation. Now moving on to the last tower. So these individual towers will be joined by a center. So center tower. So they won't be remain individual building, they will be a single building. Now we will turn the visibility on of the center tower or the center model, which will basically join the buildings. Now we have to check the model for the shell overlaps. We may reduce the tolerance, but for now we have to select the shell. So model has been checked, no error messages was found. Now delete the lines which we marked only for center line or center point. Now press the delete button on the keyboard. Let's view the building in 3D view. A more refined view can be presented from this point. So in this way we combined the four towers with a center model to create a single building. Thank you for watching. Subscribe to the channel and see the link in description to complete ETAPS course tutorials.